You've all heard the saying, defense wins championships. Well, it's true. Oklahoma, Miami, Ohio State, they all played great defense. And although defensive play calling is a very important part of it, this lesson will focus on control. And at the end of this lesson, you'll be switching, sprinting, strafing, swatting, stripping, and swimming. First things first, let's learn about switching players. You know which player you'll have control over because he'll have a star underneath him. The other 10 players are controlled by the computer. To switch players, simply press the X button. This will give you control over the next best player, not necessarily the closest player. Make sure you know which player you're controlling before you start moving him around. Once you have control of your player, there are so many things you can do. Let's start with the defensive line pass rush. When you're controlling a defensive lineman and you're getting blocked, one of the moves you can do is a spin move. To spin to the right, press the R2 button. To spin to the left, press the L2 button. This is a very effective outside move for defensive ends. For inside moves, you might want to try a swim or rip move. To swim or rip to the right, press the R1 button. To swim or rip to the left, press the L1 button. This is a good way for defensive tackles to squeeze into the gaps and disrupt the running play. For linebackers and defensive backs, a big key to success is knowing how to pursue the play and make tackles. There are times when you will need to sprint full speed to run down a play. To sprint on defense, press and hold the circle button. Just like on offense, sprinting will make you run faster, but it'll be harder to turn. A common mistake on defense is using the sprint too much and over-pursuing the play. That's where the strafe move comes into play. To use a strafe move, press and hold the R1 button. The strafe will make your player square his shoulders and break down into a good position to make the tackle. Learning the proper use of the sprint move and the strafe move will put you into great position to make plays, and that's half the battle. When you're in position to make a play on a pass, you have to decide whether you want to swat it away or go for the interception. To attempt to swat the ball away, press the L1 button. The swats are very effective in breaking up pass plays, and they're relatively low risk. So if you don't bat the ball away, you're still in pretty good position to make the tackle. But if you're an aggressive guy, then you'll probably try for more interceptions. To attempt an interception, press the triangle button. Interceptions are more difficult and have a higher risk. If you go for the pick and fail, you could give up a much bigger play than you should have. However, the reward of an interception is much greater, so the choice is yours. And speaking of aggressiveness, there are a couple more moves that you'll love if you're an aggressive player. The defensive dive is one of them. To make your player dive, press the square button. While most coaches will teach you to never leave your feet, diving can allow you to make plays that would never be possible otherwise. I see a lot of gamers out there who switch and dive. Get with it, guys. You're only hurting yourself when you do this. I suggest you dive only when you need to, like if you're making a last-ditch effort at a tackle. And the last move to learn is the strip ball. This one I love because it's very rewarding and it can be low risk if you use it in the right situation. To strip the ball, press either the L2 or R2 button. The best time to use this move is when the ball carrier is in a lot of traffic. Don't use it in one-on-one situations because you're just going to miss the tackle. Well, that wraps up this lesson in defense. Throw a little defensive play calling strategy in with these defensive control skills and you'll be a feared competitor.